in Dallas, Texas, originally started at KKDA, AM/FM, as a promotions person, and I worked for free. I loved what I was doing.
From that time, when I got to Ray, that's when I found my true love of what I wanted to be in the music industry.
That's what I wanted to do.
So on that Saturday mornings from 10 to 2, we were the only station in Houston that were playing when hip-hop wasn't so big on commercial radio. We were the ones who set that trend for the Run DMCs. And back in that time, that's when Houston was selling more hip-hop music, even out of than New York was.
I started working in Monroe, Louisiana, and from there, I left to go to Shreveport, Louisiana. I stayed there for about 10, 11 years or something like that. That's when I met all these guys.
And one thing that, the reason he brought me over, because just that Saturday, on the mornings I was on the radio, when he did research on DJs, my name came up in the research, because at that time I knew I was on the radio, I had only 4 hours to shine. And so that's what we did, so that 4 hours to shine did more for me than a lot of guys who were on 7 days a week.
From Dallas, I went to Grambling State University.
I never drive a car without a spare tire.
I used to say, Rob, it's time for me to go on the air. I said, I need you to train me. Rob said, be up here tonight at 12 a.m.
Because you can create a business, but you got to be there every day and run it. It's a job.
And I worked 12 to 6 for about probably a year. I did overnights, and on top of that, I did sales, promotions, schedule logs, everything. But that's how bad I wanted.
Don't look at what's happening right now. Look at what's going to be happening 5 years ahead from now.
And I got a chance to work with some of the big artists like Beyonce's, Jagged Edge. I had some high ones. Like I said, it was a great experience.
You never heard a rhyme sticking in mine. You never heard a rhyme sticking in mine. You never heard a rhyme sticking in mine.